In the last video, we were talking about this panel's layout. How about the central area here? Can we maybe, I don't know, use it somehow? We sure can. This area is called the home page, and it's set up from here. We can use the entire central space as a whole, or split it into equal halves. This is what I usually do, or split it in 2-to-1 ratio. Then we can select the forms we want to be shown here. Except there are no forms to choose from. The thing is that the homepage supports only explicit forms, which brings me to our next subject, implicit and explicit forms in one enterprise. As we already discussed, every metadata object have all necessary implicit, aka standard forms, that it inherited from the metadata class. If we want to change them, or we need them on the home page, we have to create them explicitly. And this is how it's done. So I'm adding a new form, and the platform is asking which standard form I want to use as a template. I have a choice of a single document form, the documents list form, and a few other options. I want to start with the documents list form. And now the platform's asking what attributes I want to see here. I'm good with the date and the number fields, and I also want the payment method and the additional info. Now we are in the forms editor, and the default form with all its bells and whistles is here for us to play with. But first, let's also add a purchases documents list form. And place both these forms to the homepage. And this is what it looks like right now. Not bad, right? Now let's talk a little bit about all these clickable links we can see here. These are called comments. Their purpose is to receive the user's input and perform the specific actions. But where did these comments come from? Let's look, for example, at these two guys. If I open the document subsystem properties, there is the comment interface button that shows all the comments from all the objects included into this subsystem. Here are the purchase and the sales comment. These comments were inherited from the documents metadata class, just like the standard attributes as we saw earlier. Each document has two standard comments. Open the documents list and open a new document form. Let's tick these checkboxes and see what happens. And now we have these two comments added to the drop-down menu here. Now, who are these guys? These are called the comment groups. Let's try and drop this comment to the important group, for example. And it gets highlighted like this. If we drop the comment to the tools group, we'll have a new drop-down menu with this comment in it. So it's all pretty straightforward, isn't it? So these were the standard comments inherited from the metadata class. All the metadata objects have them, although the set of the comments can differ depending on the class. And of course, we can create our own comment belonging to a specific metadata object, write a source code processing the comment, and then show it in the comment interface. And here is our comment. The last thing I want to show you is how to put comments to the quick menu here. It's meant to be filled up with the most often used comments, because it always gets open by default when the app starts. It's not a subsystem, so it gets set up from this menu right here. But besides that, it's pretty much the same deal. I'm just selecting the comments I want and put them into groups I need them in. And here we go.